Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazadaq coming at you through the spirit of Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shah. Romans 3:10. As it is written, there's none righteous. No, not one. No matter how righteous you think that you are, you're really not. Romans 3:23. For we all have sinned and come short to the glory of Yah. Some scriptures that I've known since 5-6 years old, still have them embanked into my memory. If you're not breaking the law, statutes, commandments of the Most High, you're still sinning. You're all sinners. Say, if you're keeping the law, statutes, and commandments, you're still sinning. You're all sinners. What are you talking about, Tazadaq? Well, you all sinners. You, and you over there. If you're keeping the law, statutes, and commandments, you're all sinners. Why do I say that? Because you have that social security card. You have that social security number. And guess what? You can't get rid of it. So you're all sinners. Even if you don't think that you are. Why? They use social security to make you feel a bit more secure. So you're all sinners and you don't even know it. You got that social security number. But nevertheless, here's some information that I wanted to share with you that some of you may know and some of you may not know. The Federal Reserve is a corporation. It's not federal. Many of you think it is, but it's not federal. It's actually known as the Central Bank of the United States. But it's an offshore company. It's not federal. It prints paper that actually represents debt. Many of you think it represents money, but the paper that they print represents debt. So when you use any form of government identification, you are referring to yourself as a corporation. Only a form of government identification renders you a corporation. You're existing within the jurisdiction of corporate law, then. And just because that you don't know this does not exonerate you from it. And there's a hit and lien against your dollar bill that you're not aware of because it represents a debt. It's not money, it represents a debt. There's a hit and lien against it. So for instance, when you pay off your vehicle, or if you go and purchase a vehicle, let's say you paid it off. But you didn't know that there's a hit and lien against that vehicle. Well, the person that actually that you bought that vehicle from could come back. The lien holder of that vehicle could come back and take that from you because there was a hit and lien against it that you wasn't aware of. So now you paid it off, but you didn't realize it was this hit and lien. So it's the same thing with your home. You paid your home off. You think that you own it. But the dollar that you think that you paid it off with represents a debt. There's a hidden lien against it. So you don't own your home. They're just letting you borrow it. You don't own your car. The government is allowing you to borrow it. You don't own your children because you registered them through the government. When you look at the original live record of birth, the next time that you know that someone's actually having a child that's being born in a hospital, have a look at their live record of birth, the mother's live record of birth that she's about to sign for her child. Well, not the mother's, but the child's that the mother's going to sign. The mother is listed, if you look at that form closely, one of the box says informant, because the mother is informing the state that she has new property for the state. So when she signs that, and is sent off to the state, whichever state that baby is born in, once she's sent off for that birth certificate, the child is registered and suddenly becomes property of the state. So when your child gets out of line and you try to, or you attempt to scold your child and do not spare the rod, as the Heavenly Father suggested in the Bible, ACS comes in, and they take the child away from you because the child is not yours in the first place because you signed this child over to the state. Biologically, the child is yours. But legally, you signed the child over. The mother was an informant that signed it over. And again, ignorance does not exonerate you. So that's what's being going. That's the game that's being played. There's an incredible game that's actually being played on us, brothers and sisters. And you don't know, but still, that does not exonerate you. So we use these federal notes as a medium of exchange. It's not paying off anything. You can't discharge a debt with a debt. The dollar bill in your pocket represents a debt. But we use it as a medium of exchange. But there's that hidden lien against it. Just thought I'll bring that out. Because I know many of you don't know this. There's something that I want to share with you also. Senate report. And if you don't believe me on this, you could actually Google it. As a matter of fact, Google Senate report 93-549. And this comes out every 2 years. None of your property belongs to you. Why? Because you're in a state of martial law. You're already in a state of a national emergency. Do you know that in the state of a national emergency, there's certain executive orders that go into place that the government actually can control all property, all forms of transportation, and so on and so forth? No, you don't know that because you know why? You don't like to read. You don't like to study. Some of you may know it. And if you know it, blessed be Yahweh. But we're already in a state of a national emergency. Say, you know how like when the World Trade Center had those planes run into it in New York, the city became locked down. Well, we were already in the state of a national emergency, but you just didn't know it because you don't read. The United States has been under dictatorial control since March the 9th, 1933. What's significant? There's that year again, March 9th, 1933. That's when she declared her bankruptcy. That's when the birth certificate actually, shortly thereafter, they made you think that it was mandatory. So, Senate report. I'm going to read you some of this. Senate report 93-549. The United States has been under dictatorial control since March 9, 1933. Report a special committee on the termination of the national emergency. Senate report 93-549. So, since 1933, the United States has been in the state of a national emergency. And you didn't even know that. Powers Act, November 19, 1973. Forward, since March the 9th, 1933, the United States has been in a state of declared national emergency. These proclamations give focus to 470 provisions of federal law. These hundreds of statutes delegate to the president, extraordinary powers, ordinarily excused by the Congress, which affect the lives of American citizens. In a host of all-encompassing manners, the vast range of powers taken together confer enough authority to rule the country without reference to normal constitutional process. Under the powers delegated by these states, the president may seize property, organize and controls the means of production, seize commodities, assign military forces abroad, institute martial law, seize and control all transportation. That means your Lexus, your coupes, your Benzes, your Benz, gone. All of it, gone. Your Range Rovers, gone. And communication, your cell phones, gone. Your BlackBerry gone. Your Android gone. Regulate the operation of private enterprise. Restrict travel. You're not going anywhere. We're going to confine you to this concentration camp over here. And in a plethora of particular ways, control the lives of all American citizens. There you have it, brothers and sisters. You've been in a state of a national emergency since 1933, and you didn't even know. Because you don't like the research, and you don't like to read, and you like to just follow the order that's given down to you by this wicked volition. I mean, this is just wickedness. There's a complete, total deception that has occurred. 99.5% of the people are in utter darkness. I don't care if you graduated from with your little BS and PhD. The vast majority of you don't know what's going on. You're going out here, you're trying to get as much money as you could get. You go out here, you get your college education, and I'm by no way advocating don't get educated in college, but you have to have something here already because they placate this facade for you, or they placate this facade that, oh, life is going to be so beautiful after you graduate from college. Now you have people coming out that have masters and PhDs, and they're not even working in their own profession that they actually studied it. You got people with PhDs now working as janitors. And there shall be no jobs, fulfilling the scriptures again. And job is public interest for private dishonest gain, when you define that in Black's Law's Dictionary. So you're referred to as human. When you define human in Black's Law's Dictionary, it says, see, monster. And a monster is someone that cannot inherit property. So, I mean, a job doesn't seem to be so good. And a human, you don't want to be that either because you're a monster. And all corporations have what is known as a human resources department. You are human resources. Deceive. A tremendous game has been pulled over on you. 99% to get money from you. So you're told to go out and seek employment. And if you do get employment, you go to the human resources. Well, we just define human as a monster. And if you do get employment, and I'm not certain that you want that. Because when you look in Black Law's Dictionary, employment, it comes from two words. Employment. M-E-M, it means for. Employ, P-L-O-Y, deceit. So employment is for deceit. Why is employment for deceit? Because you go out and you get a job, which is known as employment, and a job is what? Public interest for private dishonest gain. You're not really gaining anything. Because employment is for deceit. Employment is to make you think that you're earning money, but you're just taking in promissory notes, which are debts that have a lien against them. So when you think you paid something off, you're still paying property taxes on it. And if you don't pay your property taxes, they come and take it from you. The government comes in and they take it from you. Why? Because you did not own it in the first place, because there's a lien against this money. And there you have it. Once again, my name is Tazadaq, and we are the mouth of God today. Shalom.